sin. He'll not cast them out this evening, praise God. It's a joy to know that since we have came to the Master today and we have a relationship with Him and we're a part of the family of God, I want you to know something, my friend, today. He loves His children today. Amen. The Bible teaches us today the Lord of North End that are His. How many believe that tonight? Let everyone that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity this evening, praise God. Amen. Listen, I'm glad this evening, praise God, that He knows who we are tonight. Amen. This little song we grew up on, Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. But I like the other poem somebody said, but Jesus knows me, this I love tonight, thank God. And He knows His children tonight, praise God. If you're not His child, my friend, I want you to know you can be tonight. But before we close this meeting this evening, amen, the Lord is here tonight. His presence is real. The church is still alive tonight. Amen. Hell, my friend, is still hot. Heaven is still real for the saints this evening and for those that have trusted the Savior tonight. Amen. You're in a good place tonight to find Christ. Praise God. Amen. You have your Bibles this evening. Turn with us. Amen. To the book of Isaiah. The book of Isaiah tonight. Amen. It will fall on our hearts this evening. Praise God. You may be stand for the reading of God's word, honoring God's word tonight. Amen. Isaiah chapter 55. Amen. And verse 1, if you will, tonight. Isaiah chapter 55. If you have a 1611 King James Version Bible, it's going to read exactly like this. In verse 1, he said, ho, everyone that thirsteth, come ye to the waters. He that hath no money, come ye, buy wine, buy and eat, and yea, come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Wherefore do you spend money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which is satisfieth not? Hearken diligently unto me, and eat ye that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness. Incline your ear tonight and come unto me. Hear, and your soul shall live, and I'll make an everlasting covenant with you, even the sure mercies of David tonight. May God add a blessing on the reading of His word. Let us pray. Our Father God tonight, again we thank you that you're so gracious tonight. Amen. This evening you're so sovereign this evening, and you're so merciful tonight. Oh, you're so mighty tonight, dear God. You've allowed us again to come before your presence tonight, kind of an honor and a privilege and a joy. Lord, again, just to call upon you, depending on your strength tonight. Father, we pray your unction, your Holy Spirit tonight, and your word this evening. Speak to us this evening tonight. Speak to our heart that don't know you in the free part of forgiveness of sin. God, we pray tonight that they'll incline their ear, come for salvation tonight, and find Christ a real in our soul, and leave here a brand new creature tonight. And we'll give you praise and honor and glory for all things. For we pray and ask it in Jesus' loving name. And all God's people said again, amen tonight. You may be seated. We thank you this evening again tonight for the privilege, my friend, to come to you this evening to bring you, amen, the word of God tonight. I thought about this passage of scripture, preached on it many times. Amen. But the Lord has given us something fresh. Amen. I want to share with you tonight. Amen. Listen to me. I love that Brother Jamie to get it fresh off the press tonight. Amen. What the Lord has spoken to our heart. Amen. To give you this evening. Praise God. Now listen. Amen. Tonight, did you know what? I believe this is a call for everyone tonight. Amen. Can be saved this evening, my friend. If we'll meet the conditions of God, I believe there's a call going out. Amen. For everybody tonight that don't know Christ in the free pardon and forgiveness of sin. But listen to me tonight. Some people perhaps will say, preacher, I'm not a wealthy person. Well, my friend, listen, this tears down every excuse that there is tonight. Amen. Listen to me. Amen. He's speaking to you tonight. Amen. That thirsteth, come ye to the waters. If you don't have no money, come and buy wine, milk without money and without price today. Listen. Amen. He asked a question to us. Wherefore do you spend money for that which satisfies not? My society, we do it all the time, my friend. Amen. Listen. If your bank account's big enough that you can get many things you want today. But I'm here to tell you, after a while, amen, listen, that excitement and that desire and that zeal will leave, my friend. But I'm here to tell you tonight that there's something tonight you can get free. Amen, it don't cost you anything. Paul says, for by grace through faith are you saved. It is a gift of God. It's not of works, lest any man should boast tonight. You have to pay for it. All the Walmart can't sell it. There's not a website you can find it on. Family member can't give it to you. Amen, listen to me. Your money can't buy it. But Jesus says, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest tonight. It's still a free gift this evening. Amen, listen to me right. I begin to look at this passage of scripture tonight. I want to use for a text tonight. Many people, my friend, are living the rich lifestyle, leaving God out of the picture, out of the plan. Amen. If somebody said, preacher, amen, the wages of sin doesn't pay anything. Oh, yes, it does. The wages of sin is death. Amen. The economy may change. Your wages may change. My friend, fashions will change. But the wages of sin has never changed. It'll still be death, my friend. It'll be a lost place. Amen. Listen, of torment forever and ever and ever tonight. If the Lord willing tonight, I want to use this simple thought. There's a high cost to low living. Amen. How many believe that tonight? There's a high cost, my friend, to low living this evening. Amen. We are reminded through the Word of God this evening. Amen. In Ezekiel 18 reminds us, amen, the soul that sinneth, it shall die tonight. You hear me this evening? Sin will steal people, take people farther than they want to go, pay more than they want to pay, stay far longer than they want to stay tonight. Amen. Sin steal. My friend, listen, reaps bitter wages tonight. Amen. You can't tell. My, listen to me this evening. Amen. To that first drink, my friend, to that alcoholic today has taken. There are times, many times, that he don't regret it. Amen. I, without a doubt, he does. Amen. That man, my friend, that put that strange in his veins. A woman, my friend, boy or girl, I'm sure I can tell you tonight that many of them wished they never saw a needle tonight. Because you know why? Because Satan tonight, my friend, listen, amen, the semen has clutched their soul today. Amen, listen to me. They're trying to get a bigger thrill today than they had yesterday. But I want you to know something. There's a high cost to low living tonight. Amen. You hear me this evening? There's coming a day when the party's going to be over, my friend. Amen. You're going to have to answer today. Amen. Listen, families. Amen. Are being parted, separated. Oh, listen, children are being abandoned. Jobs are lost because of the high cost of sin today. Oh, preacher, is that all there is to it? No, my friend. Amen. Listen, I want you to think about this. We used this little expression earlier when the choir came back up. Amen. It's not over till it's over. But I said, listen, there is a message there. It's not over when it's over. Amen. When the doctor shakes his head and says, there's nothing else I can do, it's not over, my friend. You hear me today? Amen. When the death certificate is signed, it's not the end of it. It's not over, my friend. There's an eternity out there. Amen. Listen to me. And somebody said, preacher, I don't want to spend eternity. Amen. In hell, listen to me. Don't you worry, my friend. Amen. I want you to know that place of fire and brimstone, I want you to know it's forever and ever and ever. You'll not exhaust it. You'll not consume it. You'll not use it up today, because there's a high cost to low living. Come on now. Stay with me tonight. Amen. I believe this. I believe we all can realize. lives. They quoted it last night. Amen. But Jesus reminded us. Amen. Speaking of the time that we can expect him to return. He said, as it was in the days of Noah, they were eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage until the day he come. And the flood came and took them all away. My friend, listen, those are high cost to live. Amen. Well, you mean, preacher, because the Bible says the imagination of men's hearts were evil continually. Amen. Listen, I want you to know something. God said he repented him that he had made man upon the earth. Amen. Listen to me. I've got news for you, God. My friend, listen, had a people that he knew he could depend on. Amen. Listen, Noah and his family, Noah preached, called a preacher of righteousness, that God's going to destroy this earth with a flood. They never believed a word of it. Amen. Only a mist come up out of the ground and water the earth. Well, we've been a preaching, my friend, that Christ is coming back. People are not accepting it. They don't believe it today. I'm here to tell you, whether we accept it or not, my friend, the fact remains, upon the authority of God's word, he's going to return again. Amen. The Lord himself is going to descend from heaven with a shout, with a voice of an archangel at the trump of God tonight. Amen. There's going to be a high cost. That's a low living tonight. Amen. Listen to me. I mentioned it. Amen. I feel impressed tonight again to tell you. Amen. Listen tonight. You don't have to be a murderer. Amen. You don't have to be an adulterer, a gambler, a drunkard, any of these things. My friend, listen, good people are dying lost without Christ. Amen. Good morals may keep you out of jail, but it'll not keep you out of hell tonight. Jesus said to Nicodemus, you must be born again today. Amen. I'm here to tell you tonight, thank God, that God made a way for Noah and his family, that they could be saved, my friend, from the destruction that was coming upon this earth. Well, the same gracious God tonight, amen, he's got a church, he's got a people, amen, that's prepared on an old ship of Zion. We're getting ready, my friend. The Lord's got a plan. He's made a way. He's going to send his son back to get his people today. Oh, there's a high cost to low living. Amen. You know what I say? People would give 10,000 worlds like this one for one more opportunity to turn back, my friend. Amen. Say, I wish I'd have took time for Jesus today. You hear me tonight? I'm glad, my friend. Listen, he took time for you and I and gave the best that heaven had. Surely today, amen, what can we do for him? Paul says, I beseech ye therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service tonight. Amen. Well, oh, preacher, I would be saved tonight. Amen. But there are too many hypocrites. Amen. Listen, in the church, let me remind you today. They were hypocrites here when Jesus walked the earth. He called them out by name, didn't he? He put a wall on them, my friend. Amen. You hear me tonight? Thank God. But he also told the church, except your righteousness exceed the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, ye shall in no wise hear him into the kingdom of heaven today. Amen. Listen, I want you to know something. There's a high cost of low living. Amen. But listen, you don't have to be, my friend, today a scumbag. You don't have to be, amen, a low life tonight. You don't have to be any of those things that I lost without Christ tonight. Amen. Listen, you'll find yourself, amen, listening in eternity without God. Because, listen, sin has a price to pay. Sin has a price to pay today. You know the sad thing about people dying lost and going there, that awful place, is they don't have to. Jesus made a way. Amen. amen, that we can be saved tonight. Oh, I'm so glad, Brother Charlie. Amen. Thank God. I believe. Amen. In an old rugged cross. I believe in a hill far away. I believe there was a man called Jesus. Praise God. Amen. Listen, my friend that died on a cruel cross, that shed his blood today for you and I. Amen. That we could have life this evening. Praise God. Somebody said, preacher, you really believe that? I swallowed it hook, line, and sinker at one time, my friend. I allowed the Lord Jesus Christ to come into my heart tonight. I want you to know something. The same God yesterday is the same God today. It's no secret what God can do. Let me know that tonight. What he's done for others, he'll do for you tonight. Amen. Listen. Oh, I know. I've seen drunkards, my friend, made sober. Amen. I've seen drug addicts come clean. Praise God. Is that all right? Yes, listen to me. I've seen the dishonest come honest. Amen. With God today, did you know what? He'll do just exactly what he said. Amen. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. All things, behold, all things are made new tonight. Amen. He'll still do it tonight. But praise God, there's a high cost at the low living tonight. Amen. Listen to me, my friend. I said the other night, Hurricane Katrina was the United States' worst natural disaster, they tell me. Amen. Listen, 1,836 souls perished, my friend. Amen. Listen, in that storm, in the hurricanes, tornadoes, and what have you. Amen. But you know the sad thing about it is, every 19 minutes, 1,836 souls are going into hell today. Amen. You hear me this evening? The Bible says in Isaiah, hell hath enlarged her borders today. Amen. Listen, men and women, my friend, are going in that place. Amen. As intruders today, because they don't have to tonight. It wasn't prepared for them. Amen. But you hear me. There's a high cost to low living this evening. Amen. Oh, but tonight, listen to me. I've got news for you this evening. I wouldn't take nothing for my journey now. I got to make it to heaven somehow. Amen. Listen today. I've done come too far to turn back. Amen. As the sissy sang the song, that's just over the next hill. We'll be home, praise God. I can see heaven on the horizon, amen. I'll still listen. If I had to live under a rock cliff, amen, drink spring water and eat cornbread, amen, till Jesus came, amen, listen to me, my friend. It'll be worth it today, amen, to hear him say the words, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter into the joys of the Lord tonight. Amen. Oh, because listen, amen, sin has a cost tonight. Sin has a cost. Only 8 souls were saved, my friend. Amen. Listen, in the flood, from the flood. Amen. But I'm here to tell you tonight, amen, sin still has a price. Amen. Listen, where will you be in eternity? What are you going to do with Jesus? Somebody said, preacher, I don't think I'll do anything with him. Yes, you are. You're going to accept him or you're going to reject him today. It's that simple. We're all going to do something with Jesus tonight. Amen. We're going to love him, Brother Jamie, and live for him. Amen. Till he calls us home where the rapture takes place. Amen. We're going to reject him today. My friend, and hear those words. Depart from me, ye workers of iniquity. I never knew you today. Oh, isn't that sad? Isn't that some of the saddest words that an individual can hear? Amen. But sin, my friend, has a price tonight. Yes, it does. Amen. Listen, I'm here to tell you. Amen. This evening, my friend, that throughout the Word of God, amen, Jesus warned more and spoke about hell than he talked about heaven today. You hear me this evening, listen, trying to warn people not to go to that awful place tonight. Amen. Because you see, amen, there's no turning back. Amen. Listen, once that last breath leaves you, the Bible said the rich man in hell lifted up his eyes, being in torment. repent. Amen. Listen, I'll promise you, you'll not convince him that sin doesn't have a high price to pay. Yes, it does, my friend. Amen. The Bible teaches me, amen, that this rich man, my friend, the Bible said he lived. Amen. Listen, he lived presumptuously. Amen. Think about that. Amen. He had all that he could ever ask for. Amen. More today. But thou was a beggar just laid at his gate. Didn't have anything, only desiring the crumbs that fell from the rich man's table. But the Bible said, moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. Can you imagine? I don't know. That maybe the rich man may have had a servant or so to tell him, to remind him that we've got a visitor at the gate. Amen. But the rich man, he would just say, ignore him. He don't need to be there. Amen. Listen to me, my friend. But I want you to know something. There came a day that he had to give an account, the Bible says. That in rich man died, in hell he lifted up his eyes. But that beggar died, he was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom today. Amen. Oh, you know what I've often said? Amen. In a sense, praise God, we can see there were two rich men. Amen. There were two beggars. One was rich on this side, but he was a beggar on the other side. One was a beggar over here, but he was rich on the other side. Can you see that tonight? Amen. Listen, my friend. That rich man in hell lifted up his eyes, being in torments. Amen. Don't you know this? Amen. The Bible teaches us that he saw the Lazarus in the Abraham's bosom. And he asked Abraham, said, oh, Father Abraham, would you send Lazarus? Let him dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. Amen. Listen to me, my friend, tonight. In spite of what statistics tell you today, there is still a little burning hell tonight. Amen. People are going there because there's a high cost to our living today. Amen. Oh, Abraham. Now listen, he commenced to tell him, son, you remember in your lifetime, you had the good things. You had all the comforts of life, anything an individual could want. The old beggar didn't have anything. Amen. But now, I could put it in my own words, the beggar's got everything. Amen. He's got all that he needs, praise God. And now, you're tormented. He's comforted and you're tormented today. Amen. Let me tell you something tonight. There's a comfort and there's a peace of mind to a child of God. Even more, my friend, than knowing that the only fire that I ever feel, Brother Jamie, is burning in my heart tonight. Amen. To knowing tonight that my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and I'm a child of the King tonight. Amen. Listen to me, my friend. And knowing today that we have peace with God through the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Oh, listen. Thank God tonight. But you know what? Amen. After all this, amen, he says, there's a great gulf fixed. He can't, you can't come here. Neither can he come there. He said, well, could you go tell him to warn my brothers? Amen. Listen. He said, well, they had Moses and the prophets. Amen. Listen, if they wouldn't hear Moses and the prophets. Amen. Listen. He said, they won't hear one, though he rose from the dead. Is that not right? Oh, listen, my friend, it's not a popular message today. But I want you to know hell's still real today. Hell is still real today, my friend. Amen. People are going there uninvited, intruders today without Christ, because he's made a way tonight that people don't have to be lost. Amen. But they can be saved tonight. Amen. Those that believe upon him. Amen. Listen to me this evening. I want you to know something. I thought about old Paul when he stood before old King Agrippa. Some of you remember King Agrippa's words. Amen. Listen, almost, Paul, thou persuadest me to be a Christian. Almost, else persuadest me to be a Christian. My friend, listen, almost a child of God is still far from being a child of God. Amen. Listen, there's no in-between places here. We're saved or lost tonight. You hear me tonight? Thank God. Listen, my friend, we're heaven-bound tonight by the grace of God. If your sins run under the blood, but if you're lost tonight, there's only one place. Life has many choices. Eternity just has two.
Amen.
Amen. But I don't ever read where old King Agrippa ever made that decision. Brother Jamie, oh, listen, you know, therefore I would say that he found out there's a high cost to low living. Amen. I don't know where that governor, amen, old Felix, that told Paul, when I have a more convenient season, I will call for you.
Yeah.
Amen. Listen, I don't ever read where that governor ever found that convenient season, my friend, that he ever made things right with God. Amen. Listen, but I'm here to tell you today, I believe these folks found out there's a high cost to low living today. You hear me this evening? I believe today the Bible teaches us in the book of Revelation, my friend. John said it like this. He saw it. He said, listen, I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were open, and another book is open, which is the book of life. And he said, whoso's names was not found written in the book of life was cast into a lake of fire and brimstone. My friend, I want you to know something. Thousands of souls at the white throne judgment, my friend, are going to find out there's a high cost to low living.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. But tonight, praise God, listen, this has cost you nothing tonight. Amen. Oh, listen tonight, special preacher. Amen. It'll cost me the world. Let me say to you tonight, you fall in love with Jesus, my friend, that'll be a small price to pay. You fall in love with the Lord today, you get your soul fixed up with God tonight. Amen. The things you used to love, God will change your mind about it. Amen. You hear me? He'll give you a crowd to run with, a new song to sing tonight, a new place, a new direction tonight. Set your feet on a rock, as David said, and establish your goings tonight. Amen. If you'll recognize him tonight, there's a high cost to low living tonight for certain. My friends, amen, tonight, and listen to me. I don't believe there's a stop. There's not no halfway place between here, amen, and eternity. The Bible says the way that a tree falls, amen, listen, so shall it lie. It's the way it's going to raise, Brother Jamie. Oh, Jesus tells us, amen, the hour is coming, my friend. Oh, they're in the graves, are going to hear the voice. Everybody's going to stand before God somewhere. You and I are going to stand at the judgment seat of Christ, according to the word of God. If you never make that appointment, my friend, you will be at the white throne judgment for sure. Amen. But he said, listen, amen, they that have done good will come forth to the resurrection of life. They that have done evil to the resurrection of damnation. How sad tonight. The old hymnal says, thousands of people are unprepared to meet God. Unprepared to meet God today. Oh, careless soul, why will you linger today when Christ has made a way, amen, for you to be saved today? Thank God. Christ has made a way, amen, for you to have the peace. You can lay your head on a pillow tonight, knowing the seed that ever sins and under the blood tonight, by simply saying that simple prayer, amen, that the publican prayed in the temple. God be merciful unto me, a sinner. God be merciful unto me, a sinner today. Amen. Listen, mean the difference between eternal life and eternal damnation. Let us stand tonight. How many knows tonight?